have spent the last, well, nearly a year writing the biography of Dadi Janki. I'm not sure I got to the bottom of who or what she is, but maybe we will find out a little bit more tonight. Now, the theme of this evening's talk, interview, discussion is still the still mind, stillness. So what I'm going to try and hope to find out from Dadi tonight is, what is stillness? What is meant by stillness? Over the centuries, many poets, hymn writers, and religious people have talked about stillness. And it's in those moments of stillness, a lot of poets and a lot of creative people have said, that is where creativity happens. You probably all know the Christian hymn, Dear Lord, Father of Mankind, which has got the refrain, the still small voice of calm. And stillness and calmness is at the heart of most religions. But what does it actually mean? What exactly is stillness? So the two main questions I want to put to Dadi tonight is, what is stillness? And also, what is the mind? Is it the same as the brain, or is it different? Is it a different entity? So I'd like to start by asking Dadi what she understands by stillness. It's not necessarily the same as doing nothing.
So first of all, actually, Dadi'd like to be able to see the audience, so if we can have the house lights on, so she can see people's faces and eyes. This is how Dadi really connects with everyone.
Yeah, I can see them now.
Yeah. Good. You can see well now. You can have a little bit more, please. We're not here on for a performance, you see. This is not a play. It's real heart connection. Okay?
And you like
also. A little bit more if possible.
And for each other.
So before Dadi begins at any place,
like tomorrow,
it's a like
right.
And he asked him, where are the microphones? I said, here they are. So she said, they can all hear you. I said, yes, I think they can hear us with these microphones. So Dadi says, whenever she begins, first of all, she always likes to greet everyone with Om Shanti. Om Shanti means I am the essence of peace. And she usually says Om Shanti three times.
Om Shanti Om.
And why is it that I'll tell you in a minute why it is that I like to say Om Shanti first.
Om Shanti.
Then who I belong to.
Sansara mein mujhe kya karne ka hai.
And then, of course, the third understanding that is necessary is to understand what it is that I have to do in today's world. And so it's not possible to stabilize the mind or still the mind if I look outside and say, what's this one doing? What's that one doing? What's the other one doing? And it's, we don't need to give time to that thinking. This world is a drama, a play.
I'm still trying
to...
And the understanding that is necessary to still the mind is each one has their own role to play in this drama.
I still want an answer to my question. What exactly is stillness? What does Dadi understand by stillness?
No, stillness kya hai? Ekagrata kya hai?
Man kya kya ho raha hai?
Man ki ekagrata kya hai? Ye batao pehle.
Pehle ye
batao.
Acha man ki ekagrata.
Stillness, sthirta.
Samjha, samjha. Acha. मन जब कहते हैं ना अंदर है और दिल या
we speak about the mind being inside and we put our hand on our heart
दिल
we speak about the heart
दिल या
we put our hand on our heart when we speak about the heart
मन कहेंगे मन की शांति चाहिए दिल के खुशी चाहिए
when we speak about the mind we speak about peace of mind when we speak about the heart we speak about happiness of the heart
मन कहेगा शांति
the mind wants peace
दिल कहती है मुझे खुशी
the heart says I want happiness
we talk about that we yes. talk about peace of mind and peace of mind has become a bit of a cliche these days because when insurance people ring you up, they say they're going to give you peace of mind. And just about every product you can buy, you can buy extra peace of mind, as it's called. Now, this is not really what Dadi means by peace of mind. So what exactly is peace of mind? How do we attain peace of mind and what is it?
कैसे प्राप्त हो और क्या चीज है क्या है मन की शांति
बहन पहले आपने कहा एकाग्रता की शक्ति क्या है
First of all, you asked the question about stillness of the mind. You haven't finished yet.
I want the answer. What is a still mind? What's stillness? And is it any different from peace of mind?
Man ki shanti aur man ki ekagrata sthirta isme farak hai.
Thoda mujhe samajh karne dena.
So you have to give me time to clarify.
I know these are not easy questions to answer, but
mujhe pata hai ye prashn sahaj nahi hai jawab karne. जवाब देना लेकिन she needs time
मैं जवाब दे
yeah I will give you answers
because okay. I think that we would all like to have stillness of mind we would all like to have peace of mind I mean what I understand by peace of mind is that I'm not going to let anything trouble me I'm not going to let anything cause me stress and I'm not going to let anything trouble me, or at least not trouble me for a very long time. Nowadays, a lot of people suffer from stress chronically,
And so I think one of the reasons that people are here tonight is that they'd like an answer as to how to reduce or eliminate stress and worry and troubles from their life and attain the kind of peace of mind which, quite honestly, has enabled Dadi to achieve what she has achieved.
You've given me so much to talk about, so much work. Talking about peace of mind. You're also talking about stillness of the mind. Actually, when it comes to stillness, then you have to engage the intellect as well. When the mind is peaceful, then the intellect goes inside, it becomes introspective. We have to understand this contrast between being extrovert, where our attention is focused outside, and introvert, where the attention is focused inside. Actually, there are five aspects that you need to understand the stillness of the mind. One is purity. Purity in the sense cleanliness of the self. There has to be so much cleanliness, so much purity, that there are no unclean thoughts in the mind. Let me finish one thing at a time.
Sorry, I was just going to ask Dadi if she could give an example of an unclean thought.
So, ashuddha sankalpa, impure vicharita, misalsunao. Misalsunao, impure sankalpa.
Impure sukasa. Dukkha sukha. Thora sukha. Sunyata.
So that is defining unclean or impure thinking, is where we base our inner state of being on things that are temporary and false. For example, if somebody praises you and says good things about you, you become very happy and pleased. If somebody says something that is not so pleasant, you become unhappy. So this false happiness that you take from the praise, that would be considered unclean or impure. If we fail, for instance, at something, we become very unhappy. And if we are successful at something, we become
happy.
And so this inner state of being depends on these external factors. This would be unclean.
Yes. Yes. Well, that clarifies it, because what we're saying, what Dadi is saying now, as I understand it, is that it's when we're swayed this way and that by either external events or by other people's opinions of us. We can be happy if they praise us, sad if they revile us, and what Dadi is saying, we should remain in the same state of mind, whatever the external.
Absolutely right. So I can clarify it a bit
further.
Actually, when we start to practice being introverted and go inside ourselves, then we free ourselves from these changing external factors.
Hindi mein, two shabd mein kehti hoon, parayi baat, purani baat.
We speak about these two aspects, things that are of other people, things of the past. These two aspects I have to let go of. How many times have I met you? All the time that I've known you. Not many times. Daddy knows that you have very real and subtle love for Daddy, and that whenever you meet with her, then you're always able to take something from her.
That's true. It doesn't always last, though.
Say about it. It's actually when we find something useful for ourselves, and we always feel it's not just useful for me, but it's useful for others too. And then we share with others, and you share by writing.
Yes, but what I now wanted to ask is, we talked about not being affected by externals, but is there a difference between a still mind and a stable mind? Because as I said earlier, a lot of poets have spoken about stillness, and that's where creativity happens.
First, we have to make our mind peaceful, in a sense, still. And then we have to make the intellect stable. And when the mind, until my mind becomes very still and peaceful, then I can't experience that stability. And that's why Daddy uses this expression, Om Shanti, to make her mind still and peaceful. So the moment you say Om Shanti with that understanding, you're able to be still inside.
But when we're speaking about stillness and the still mind, a lot of creative people have said that's where they hear things. They hear things they wouldn't otherwise hear, and that gives them inspiration.
So the five things that he wanted to share, she hasn't quite finished sharing them, she's only shared the first one. So this will answer some of the questions that you're asking. So the second aspect is truth. To go into the aspect of truth, going to the depth of that. Because when there is truth, then you're able to have patience. So the third aspect that's required is patience. And if when there isn't patience, then we rush into thinking very quickly. You have five fingers. This one is little. This one is big. This is a little finger, which we actually use as a symbolism of cooperation. Everyone gives a little finger and something becomes possible. And the second finger is always used to signify victory. And the third finger is the finger of wisdom. And this one points upwards towards God, who enables everything to happen.
Do you think, Daddy, that
we that God is a sign of determination? So it's these five fingers that enable something to happen. So that's still onto the 5 points yet, which hasn't quite finished yet. So
what I wondered is if we manage to acquire a still mind, are truths revealed to us that we wouldn't otherwise be able to access?
तो उसमें तो हमको सत्यता नहीं प्राप्त होती है, उससे तो सत्यता प्राप्त होती है, आत्मा सत्यता तो हो तब स्थिर मन होता है, तो ये कहते स्थिर मन होता है तब सत्यता प्राप्त होती है, समझ में आती है।
अबे क्या करूं, इतनी बड़ी सभा के बीच में एक एक बात मन को शांत करना है, बुद्धि को स्थिर करना है।
We have to make the mind peaceful and we have to make the intellect stable and still.
Well, this brings me on to my next question, which is probably the most difficult one for most of us. Not a difficult question to ask, but a difficult thing to achieve. How do we make our mind still and stable?
मुझे एकांत चाहिए।
To make the mind peaceful, first of all, means to have less thoughts. And in order to have less thoughts, what is helpful is to have spent time in solitude. And solitude, this word in Hindi is very interesting. Ekant, to go into the depth of one thing. To go into the depth of one.
Bale, abhi suno, karobar tumhari jo ghar paal paal ghar ki hogi, pure apne karobar jo
All of you have lots of activity, you have business to attend to, your business of your personal business or family business or whatever it might be, but you can imagine that he says the activity and the business that she has to attend to, which is of a whole organization. And whenever we are carrying out any activity, we need to pay attention to our words and our actions, but there should be no tension. Instead of change the word tension into attention, just by putting the letter A in front of tension.
So what tension free hone de, attention rakhne de, jo mujhe zaruri baat hai na.
When we keep ourselves free from tension and pay attention, then whatever it is that is necessary, actually our mind is able to be touched by that. And so then, and our activity, our words, our interactions with others will be very pleasant. And others will enjoy their interactions with us.
74 में मुझे भारत में कहा तो तुम विदेश में जाओ केंद्रीय ने कहा मैं जानती हूँ केंद्रीय ने कहा मैं नहीं जाएंगे अकेले ये चले तुम्हें जाएंगे
In 1974, Dadi was asked to come to England for the first time. And Sister Janki, some of you know her, and she speaks English, Dadi didn't speak English, and she said she's not going to come to England, you know Sister Janki, until Dadi joins her here.
मुझे तभी लंदन लगता था,
And I thought to myself at that time, London, so far away, what am I going to go and do in London?
Not only is it far away, but it's a very noisy place, not much stillness in London.
London बहुत दूर भी है, लेकिन बहुत आवाज़ वाला भी है, बहुत आवाज़ होता है.
मतलब
शांति नहीं.
माया भी है.
Yes, there's a lot there. Lots of distractions here, lots of attractions that distract people from themselves, whether it's the way they dress and the way they present themselves. But actually, when I came in 74, I came with three sets of clothes, very simple three sets of clothes.
Can I just go back to solitude? Dadi spoke about solitude. We need to have more solitude. Now, I know a lot of people are very nervous in solitude and they are being lonely. And often, as we know now, when people are widowed or divorced, the first thing they try and do is to find another partner because they're frightened of being alone, they're frightened of being on their own. Now, can Dadi please explain the difference between solitude and loneliness?
When we go into solitude, then we go deep inside ourselves. And when you go into the depths in that way by yourself, then there is richness inside you. And this richness enables you to feel good in all circumstances and situations. Dadi was in Morocco, she said recently, where she met all sorts of people, but there was no discomfort inside her at all because she has that inner richness. In the
so is Dadi saying that if we are able to spend more time in solitude, we will access a richer inner life than if we don't try to spend some time in solitude?
So Dadi is saying yes, when you do spend time in yourself, this recognition of the inner self, the spiritual self, then yes, you will be able to emerge all the richness that exists inside the soul.
Man, beat me, hold it.
I'm interrupting you, she says.
Sorry, life, no waste of time.
We are
money. Well, we are energy.
So then he says, what actually makes you realize your richness also is because she says she doesn't waste her time, she doesn't waste her money, and she doesn't waste her energy. Even though, and she doesn't even carry a handbag with herself.
Well, all through the ages, in most religions, the ideas of simplicity, purity, not having many possessions, has always been part of spirituality. But nowadays, it seems people have ever more possessions. I mean, there was something I read recently about how many clothes people got nowadays compared to how many clothes they had in the 1970s. And how many pairs of shoes compared to how many they had 30 or 40 years ago. It seems that we're getting ever more possessions and ever more acquiring ever more things. Dadi wants to take us back to a greater simplicity. Is this true?
Dadi is explaining a little bit of her own simple life. And Dadi says that you probably have been to Kingston Road, where we had a center in northwest London, in Kilburn. She said it was a very tiny little room at that time, really tiny, half this, one third of the size of this stage, and four sisters used to live in this one little tiny space. And the expenses of the week were £13 a week at that time.
What's the matter? Way back in 18.
One particular lady came, quite elderly, and she said to Daddy, I want to make a life like yours. So she said to Daddy, but I go to a hairdresser regularly. Does that mean I have to stop going to a hairdresser? And she said, but yeah, it does cost me a bit, but I don't think I can quite be without my hair the way
it is. Well, I feel exactly the same. I had to be without my hairdresser. But it is certainly is true, it's true in the West, and it's, I think it's also true in India, that we are now accumulating ever more possessions. Children have got more toys than they have ever had before in the whole history. More devices, iPhones, iPads, all sorts of things that even I didn't have as a child. So what is this telling us, all these possessions that we keep acquiring?
इतने सब चीजें इकट्ठी करने से जैसे बैग फलाना टीरा इकट्ठा करके कहाँ जाएंगे कहाँ स्थूल
So the reason, it's true, the reason why people accumulate is because their attention is focused outside. The attention focused outside means to see what there is out there, to want what there is, to compare with other people. Comparing means that if somebody else has it, I have to have it, the shoes they have, whatever it is. It's seeing the attention focused outside
so
means the acquiring of possession.
So does this
mean in London may shopping here?
That he says I've been that he doesn't live in London now, but when she was here for 40 years and she said she's never been out shopping even during that time.
Retail therapy is called.
If somebody says to Daddy, do you want to go shopping? Yeah. She says, no, I don't need to go shopping.
But would Daddy
admit?
So you spend money when you go out shopping and you also waste your time. And then it becomes a habit to go out shopping.
Would Daddy say...
People don't like to cook at home and eat food that they've prepared, but they like to go to a restaurant or they go out. They have to go out at night to eat outside to feel good about themselves.
That's true. But would Daddy say... Would Daddy say that all this external stuff, going out to restaurants, shopping, acquiring things, takes us away from stillness of the mind?
Yes, absolutely. It's not possible to keep the mind still if you are distracted by all these things. A, you want this and that and the other. Once you have it, you have spent time and mental energy to look after it. To stay in solitude, make the intellect pure. To make the mind peaceful. To recognize the truth that exists inside the self and to emerge that from within the self.
So we need.
We've wasted a lot of time throughout our life.
So what we need to do is to make regular time to sit in silence and to try and experience the stillness of the mind. Now, I do know that when a lot of people sit in meditation or try to sit in meditation, that their mind becomes very active and disturbed. So how do we get from being disturbed and all sorts of unwelcome thoughts troubling us to the stillness that Dadi is talking about?
क्या करें कैसे करें ये शब्द ना बोलते हैं ऐसे करें ये करें.
And what also tends to happen is that we can get caught up in asking, how can I do it? How is it possible? But actually, you just have to sit down and do it. And recognize, this is how I have to do it.
But
find
it does,
out and do it.
It does take practice.
Abhyas chayena. Abhyas chayena iske liye.
Abhyas abhi chayena. Jab uska paida.
Yes, it is true. You need practice, but the practice, when there is the pull for, when there's a desire for that, you have to do it so that you gain experience, then you're going to want to develop the practice. We have to draw ourselves away from these external things that keep distracting us, so that we can spend time inside and create interest in wanting to do that. People earn a lot of money. Why? Because they have interest to do that.
Interest.
And then when you have interest in something, then you have interest in creating interest in what you earn.
A lot of us are very busy these days. So is it possible to be very busy and to have a still mind?
Busy, what are people busy with?
Well, we're busy with jobs, we're busy with families.
People are busy as well as lazy.
So we're busy and lazy.
Lazy for these things, the mental things. We're lazy for the mental things.
So
people go to bed late at night and they wake up late in the morning.
I think that is a very profound point that Dadi has made, which is probably more relevant today than it's ever been, that we are both incredibly busy these days and incredibly lazy.
It's true though, actually people are busy doing a lot of external things, but to go inside and to look at the self, for that you need a peaceful mind, you need a patient mind, and you need to give attention to it.
And also, would Dadi say you need discipline to have a very ordered life?
Discipline bhi chahiye na, man ko ye karne ke liye discipline bhi chahiye na.
Yeah.
Discipline chahiye.
Discipline.
Yes. You need discipline.
No. Discipline अच्छा का भी practically life में value.
It's true. Actually, we do have to give value to discipline too.
The thing is that what I find is the more discipline you have, the more you can get done. And also, if you have a routine in life, you can be very busy and have a still, you know, still mind, but you do need discipline and routine. You cannot be chaotic and have a still mind. Am I
right?
Discipline पहले रखना है पर क्यों रखेंगे समझेंगे मुझे ये कुछ लाइफ अच्छी बनानी है
इट्स ट्रू
दुनिया में मैं कहती हूँ सिंपल बनना है सिंपल रहने के लिए
इट्स ट्रू
रहते सिंपल बनने के लिए
वी हैव टू आस्क आवरसेल्व्स द क्वेश्चन व्हाई डू वी वांट द डिसिप्लिन व्हाट डिसिप्लिन इन आवर लाइव्स To have discipline in order to make a life that is simple and a simple life that becomes an example and an inspiration for others to follow.
So, ये बुकल तो मेरा नहीं लिख रही हो, बहुत बुकल लिखी है, interesting बात
है. You've not just written a book about Dadi, as you were saying recently, but you've written many books. Why? Because you personally have interest in doing that.
The thing about being a writer, as within any creative pursuit, it's not really that you've got an interest in it. It's that you can't not do it.
वो कहती है वो तो कर रही हूँ पर मुझे अभी ये कर रही हूँ अभी सुनो एक मिनट इलेजा मार के पूछ रही है सभी को ये समझ में आता है जरूरी है
That is, Liz is asking Dadi questions, but do you all feel you identify with the questions and the answers or this conversation? Do you identify with it or not? Yes? If you can't a yes or no, then you'll know what's going on. So if you feel it's relevant to you in your life, can you raise your hand, please? Thank you. This is not a theatre where you've come to watch a performance, right?
Interactive.
Yeah.
Yes, I think that Dadi has given us a lot of food for thought. But what I also want to know is, how do I know when I've got a still mind or a stable mind? How do I know the difference?
मैं कितना दुनिया दस दिन दो तीन बारी मिलना
That is saying that that is around for about 10 days more in the UK. You must come and see her more often. At least two or three times, she says.
Yes, but that, many of us, particularly a lot of people in the audience and I, don't have the opportunity to sit in front of Dadi very often. So what I'm saying is, how do I feel different if I have a still mind? Do I feel lonely? Do I feel comfortable? What are the differences?
आपके संग और ये फायदा मिले
आपके अंदर क्या फीलिंग
मन को शांत बुद्धि को स्थिर एकांत प्रिय उसके लिए पहले एकांत प्रिय फिर मन को क्यों एकांत में है एकांत में क्यों डीप जाने के लिए
फीलिंग क्या है इनके अंदर फीलिंग क्या होगी क्या फीलिंग होगी मन जब एकांत जब फील होता है तो अपने अंदर फीलिंग्स क्या आएगी क्या फील करेंगे
बस अरे इसके लिए तो मैं बहुत तरसती थी
There is the feeling of rest. The rest and the peace of the mind will make you feel that The day that you have been waiting for in your life has arrived.
And that will be every day, will it?
And you will appreciate that time in your life, those moments where you learn to do that.
And so I won't have down times or depressed times. I think we all know how many millions of pounds are spent on antidepressant pills in the UK alone. I think they are now the most commonly prescribed medication.
Yes, it's true, all the pharmacies will close down. Won't be a need.
So we can overcome
the depression.
Yes, I feel great mercy for those who I see are in depression. And in that state, one becomes disheartened. And if somebody else feels a bit better, they also compare themselves with them, and they feel jealous as well. And then there's the birth of the illness of jealousy.
Well, you see, we probably all heard of the actor Robin Williams. One of the most successful Hollywood actors of all time committed suicide suffering from depression. So, you know, it affects all of us, high and low.
Yes, it's true. In fact, it's in the state of depression, not only people cause harm to themselves, but cause harm to others. So somebody asked a question to Dadi this morning on the way here, in fact. Somebody died recently. She says he was only 49 years of age, and so Dadi was asked this question. Why would he have died like that? And Dadi said, well, and Dadi was shown the photograph of this person, and Dadi said, he's young, and must be because of something of that kind that had disturbed that individual to such an extent that they had become depressed or unhappy. And this can also cause death, not necessarily suicide, but can cause death.
But it is a big problem in our age. It's a big disease nowadays that many people suffer from. And
three things that can comfort the heart.
Life mein madad hai. Suno, jo hamara dikhaya tha na, Brahma Baba ka photo bhi dikhaya tha. अभी ब्रह्मा बाबा तो 69 में अरेस्ट हो गए, उसके बाद भी देश की सेवा शुरू हुई है, पर मेरी अंदर भावना क्या है, मैं क्या कर रही हूँ, अच्छे वाइब्रेशन, एक है वातावरण, जैसी वार्ता, ऐसा वायुमंडल पर बन जाता है, वाइब्रेशन दूर चली जाता है.
So that is saying that actually there are the important things to support these kinds of people is for us to be able to create a good atmosphere. The atmosphere is created through the quality of our conversations. That when the quality of our conversations is very high, then the energy and the atmosphere created is very high. This atmosphere then helps these people, in a sense, who can't really help themselves. And the second aspect is of giving vibrations. Atmosphere is created in an immediate environment. The other is vibration, to create such a positive inner state of being that it creates a vibration that reaches far into the distance. And those vibrations then help other people too, which is people who are far away. This is what we have to do in order to support other people who are not able to help themselves.
I'm afraid we have to tie up now. We could keep Dadi talking all night because there's so much wisdom coming out all the time. But I'm afraid we've now run out of time. And I'd now like to ask Linda if she could please lead us in a little experience of the stillness that we've been talking about.
मैं समझती हूँ इसके बाद तुम मेरे से बैठो जाए यहाँ हर सप्ताह होगा
So that is saying that there should be a program happening here every week and you can all come here every week That is saying that you have been made the instrument, if you like, to ask these questions to Dadi. If you want to bring benefit to other people, you can make anything happen.